Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte opened and closed his State of the Nation address by taking a swipe at Senate Minority Leader Franklin Drilon. But the opposition lawmaker rebuts attacks against him. Drilon points out that the water concession agreement was sealed during the Ramos administration, and he had nothing to do with it. Drilon also maintains he has filed a bill that will regulate political dynasties. Drilon also clarifies he wasn't defending the Lopez family, but he instead took up the cudgels for press freedom.
Dinepensa ko po yung ABS-CBN. Wala po akong utang na loob sa mga Lopez's. Aking dinepensa ang kalayaan sa pagmamahayag. Lalo na ngayon na kailangan ng taong bayan ang impormasyon tungkol sa COVID-19.
Opo.
At malaki ang papel po ng ABS-CBN doon. At pangalawa, so yung ating mga kasamahan, 11,000 mga manggagawa sa ABS-CBN, mawala ng trabaho.
Other opposition lawmakers came to Drilon's defense.
Malinaw na rin ngayon na yung pagpapasara sa ABS-CBN, hindi nga siya neutral doon. Talagang gustong-gusto niyang ipasara ito at sinunod naman ito ng kanyang mga kaalyado sa Congress.
Opposition lawmakers also pointed out that the president's speech fell short of addressing the COVID-19 pandemic.
Wala pa rin namang binanggit kaugnay dito. Sinabi ngayon ay recovery plan para sa malalaking negosyo at oligarkiya at hindi naman pagbangon ng ordinaryong mamamayan. Nariyan yung pagbabawas sa buwis ng mga korporasyon.
It is completely disappointing for the president not to make a clear discussion of the administration's stimulus package and just rely on a small amount in the Bayanihan Act Part 2.
Walang malinaw na pagtingin na the response to the health and economic crisis. It was so rambling all over the place.
Allies, however, backed the president's speech. Senate President Vicente Soto III urged telecom companies to heed the president's push for better services. Soto also expressed openness to reopen deliberations on the death penalty. For PBA Partialist Representative Jericho Nograles, most of the laws Duterte asked for have already hurdled the House and are pending before the Senate. Meanwhile, House Majority Leader Martin Romualde sums up the president's speech to be about livelihood, safety, and progress. And he says the House leadership is more than ready to help the president achieve his goals. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.